And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
It's Wednesday, 6 p.m. It's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder, and that's Big J. Oakerson.
Just like that.
And that new theme song, entrance song, whatever you call it, it's got the blood boiling.
It's good.
It's good. That's good. Real good.
It's good.
It's real good.
It's good.
It's good. It's real good. If you don't know what the show is, this is Big J. Oakerson and I hashing out all the political issues of the day.
Just really breaking everything down.
Trade tariffs.
Twerking at an all-time high. This is always funny. The days you come over and we play video games first, there's always a moment of the day where our friendship is on the rocks.
Yeah, because you're, you're terrible at losing at video games. I'm way better at losing. I'm bad at it, but I'm better at losing at video games than you are.
You think so?
Dude, you completely shut down.
You think so?
Yeah. I go mad, but I burn hot and I burn quick.
At a game to 21 in basketball, when it was fucking 14-3, yeah. I did pout in the corner.
You did.
And then Dan just went, forget the whole thing. Let's turn the whole game off then.
Yeah.
I just finished it. I don't care. Let's stop the whole thing.
Yeah, you're being bummed out made me upset. In fact, someone just tweeted us that new Madden comes out next week and they want to play us.
I can't believe it comes out so fast.
I know. But that's going to be...
Why do they come out way before they have the actual finished roster? I know you get the roster.
Well, it pumps people up for football.
Yeah.
Yeah, like for casual fans. If you don't like the preseason...
But the thing is, that's 4 weeks of playing it. That I can't really play the season because I don't know what the final roster is.
Well, that's but here's
I can't
the thing.
Go into my season with like a roster that's wrong.
Well, yeah, but then you also that's what they want you to do because they want you to start over again. It's all the NFL. The NFL just wants to get you. Like, I hate you.
You think the NFL's behind the release time of that?
Yeah, absolutely. I bet they coordinate everything. I mean, they have the licensing agreement.
I always thought it was an EA Sports thing.
No. But how many times...
Am I crazy low? I always feel like it sounds weird.
I think you sound great. Christine's in Crack Corner. Hi, Christine.
Hey, Christine. The whole gang's here.
You're really pissed that Merc-Face Andy put you in a corner.
Look what Christine did.
Hey.
Look what she figured out for us.
Yeah, you took down the fucking Entertainment Weekly people that spilled coffee all over the new console.
They don't give a shit.
They act like they're so much better than us. I just don't like that. I'm really turning into white trash right now. They think they're better than us, and I'm going to fight them.
I looked really good that day in that picture.
What, on the Bonfire picture?
This might be my best picture ever.
Can I just say my baby blues are popping in that?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. They're dominating my baby blues, just like your point guard team dominated my point guard team.
But if we mix them together, it's NBA like the ocean. And it's a sea of hilarity. Hey, speaking of the NFL, our super fan, Tyler in Arizona, he gave you Road Pig on Monday.
Yeah, so cool.
And I forgot half of it. He got me an awesome Macho Man shirt, and he got me a Cobra Kai Dojo shirt, which I...
Really? That's so awesome.
Which I've been wearing to bed, Tyler.
You get up and make yourself eggs just wearing underwear and that.
Becky Young comes in and just sees the bottom part of my hairy ass.
Hey.
Hi, Mike.
I thought you were still sleeping, Angel.
Hey, Sleepy. Hi, Sleepy. But
Angel.
Tyler gave me this to give to you, and it is a Philadelphia Eagles long sleeve shirt.
Sick.
Yeah, bro. That's a throwback.
I likes that.
1933, dog.
No shit. That was a good year for them. Thank you. This is Tyler also?
Tyler in Arizona.
Tyler came up big.
So, you know. Tyler's if you're wondering who our favorite camper is, Sarah McPants, I don't remember getting a gift from
Sarah
you.
Sarah brought jack shit.
Oh, you bring me some witty tweets?
She brought a guy she was boning.
Oh, and then another gift. By the way, Sarah McPants, I was just kidding. You know your top
counselor. Of course. She's head count. Oh, wow. Oh. Our big Shonoff picture's here, too.
Holy shit. Let me read the note that comes with it. It's Jason Malkin. He wrote, Dan and Jay, I hope you guys enjoy this piece. This is a small gesture for the amount of entertainment both of you have given me. Well,
it's a large gesture.
Jason, that is an uncomfortably large gesture, but
thank
we really
so
appreciate
much,
it. And seriously, dude, it's fucking awesome.
Not only are we going to enjoy it, but how much the Entertainment Weekly people are going to hate it is what makes me the most happy. Jacob, you're making a face. You don't think we're going to be able to get this thing up in the studio, do you?
I think eventually we'll work it out.
Can Jay and I come in the studio when Entertainment Weekly's here and tell them to kiss our Converses?
Yes. Oh, how great would that be? Let's just storm their show and do that whole thing.
When I say, who is the master, you say,
Jonah!
Bonfire!
Jonah! That's fucking great. I heard you got some coolie-ass what's up Entertainment Weekly out here claiming they're the last dragon.
Oh.
We've missed so many Last Dragon events, it turns out. I'm so bummed.
We were at the standing room last week, and Janelle James, very funny comedian, told us about they did a screening.
Yeah, and Ty Mac, Bruce Leroy,
yeah,
and El DeBars at the show. Doing a Q&A thing. Missed that. Apparently there was an anniversary thing last year in Brooklyn, and they did a big thing with Timac. We should get Timac.
We gotta probably get him.
I think he's easy to get on things. People have told me they've had him on stuff before.
I bet we could get him to fight Jacob in a last chat. If we could dress up Jacob like a tiny Chonuff.
Jacob Kip-a-Patat?
Dude.
I'm calling him Kip.
Wait, by the way, I believe, I might be wrong, but I think in one of the fight scenes, Chonuff does do a Kip-up.
He absolutely does a Kip-up.
So we might have to dress up Jacob as a tiny white Chonuff.
Can you put on Chonuff Kip-up? It's when he fights. It's in the underground fight when Eddie Arcadian comes to meet him.
Yes.
And he goes down the ground, he does a kip up and beats the shit out of the guy.
So we need to get Bruce Leroy on the show, and we're going to dress you up as Shonuff to kip up. And then you go,
when I say who is the master, you say Jacob. You heard me, Cooley. Kiss him. Kiss my Jaw shoes. I was in Jaw. Kiss my New Balances.
Yeah, kiss my New Balances. Jacob got new awesome. Where did you get those?
Where'd I get them?
Yeah.
I got them at Bass Pro.
Bass Pro? That's where they were selling Jaw shoes? Dude, I just have a feeling that you're just going around buying shoes at gun stores.
Yeah, if Last Dragon's on in the background, you can't focus on a conversation. It's impossible. Yeah, I watched the fight scene every time at the end, like maybe it's going to go different. You can't do that to my brother. How did that kid die? Can we look up how Richie the...
I've always come out of the bathtub like that, though, when I finally get the glow.
You splash up like that after you go through a series of memories you're in the water, people just telling you you're better.
Yeah, it's Gary forgetting to send me a birthday card, and then I come out of the water like that.
Who's your father? I am. I'm my own father.
My mother's my father.
Yeah, Trish.
She was both parents.
Trish.
When you get the glow, we're going to do some singing later. I'm pretty excited about that. Just a little tease.
Yeah, we have a guest coming in.
We have our guest, Nikki Glaser from the show Not Safe.
And on Comedy Central, Television.
Television. She's going to be at Caroline's all weekend. So yeah. Go see her if you're in New York. She's fucking hilarious.
And we are, she is hilarious. I've known Nikki for so long now.
Yeah.
She
came up.
She opened for me in San Fran.
I wish she would come in an hour and a half earlier so we could do Glaser stories, too.
Are there good Glazers? Oh, Craig.
Yeah.
Oh, we're gonna get into that. We're gonna get into that. Don't worry. We're gonna get into the correct later stuff. We'll watch some man and his dog later.
Oh, God. Dude, even the thought of that makes me.
Do we need a taste?
Laughing.
Do we need a taste of man and his dog? There's five more episodes.
You wanna do a gummer?
Yeah, let's get a little gummer right now. Christine, if you could bring up
a man and his dog.
Let's do episode. Let's go to five.
But Nikki started in. This is what's crazy about when. There's very few comedians that start on the road and get successful. Yeah. She's one of them. Daniel Tosh was one of them. Tommy Jonigan. Very few that can, like, start on the road and then make it, like, move to a big city and make it.
Yeah. Oh, here we go. Man and his dog.
Craig Glaser.
You guys ready?
I'm Marlon.
Are you?
Yep.
Hey, we're back for episode 5 of Man and His Dog. These are my two dogs. They're my whole family. This is Junior, the little miniature dog that my wife Connie bought me when we got married over 13, 14 years ago.
Remember?
She told me it would help our marriage last
Pause
year.
It. Pause it. That dog is just that dog's clearly blind and about to die. He just keeps lifting it up, and the dog's like,
Everything's fine, right, Junior? Tell him everything's fine.
He sounds like Beetlejuice.
I'm the ghost with the most, baby.
It's true, Glaser.
Now, this dog over here fits inside of a vagina. How do I know that? Ask some whore named Candy Apples who works over at the.
I had to stuff him in.
Pump and dump.
I had to stuff him in with my elbow. Go ahead. Oh, we're starting to get.
You guys ready?
I'm Marlon.
Are you?
Yep.
Hey, we're back for episode 5 of Man and His Dog. These are my two dogs. They're my whole family. This is Junior, the little miniature dog that my wife Connie bought me.
Blind as a bat.
13, 14 years ago.
It just looks like he's beating retarded.
Our marriage lasts forever. Forever's 4.5 years.
Same this joke. Coco, same joke.
The dog that Chuck Lebecki from 98.9 The Rock that you used to be on with us and I went out with for a bit brought me over on a Friday and said she'd pick him up Monday. and that was 4.5 years ago. So here they are, the man and his dog. These are my buddies. You know, a lot of famous people play at Stanford's over our more than four decades of being in business. We are the oldest comedy club in the world, except for the Comedy Store, which is owned by Pauly Shore's mom, and it was his dad. They're divorced, and his brother, and that's the Comedy Store in Sunset. So we're 41 years old. And I guess they're probably like over 50 years old. I'm not sure exactly. But we used to have all the big stars come in the 80s, early 90s when those guys couldn't get work. If you weren't Jimmy Walker or Gabe Kaplan,
dude,
no one heard of
straight, pause it. He's just straight grabbing those dogs. Those dogs want nothing more than
stay put, goddammit. Where are you going? What the fuck?
I'm going to tell a story.
You want to get kicked again or you want to get this goddamn webcast done?
Oh! Very exciting.
Wow.
I mean, something like this happens.
This is beauty of Sirius Radio.
Something like this only happens once every 2 months.
The great, great Ron Bennington.
Coming by
in studio.
And picks the Eagles chair.
You know,
he gets it.
I'm in here working late. You know, we just did the Comedy 101 show. And they asked me to come in tonight and edit out all of Metzger before.
I heard most of your show today, but did you guys talk about the heat he's getting at all?
Yeah, yeah. Well, it was actually exploding more and more.
When you were on?
Yeah, as I was on, and I'm like, I don't, you know, I certainly don't want to add to it.
Yeah.
But, a lot happened even after.
Good Lord, what a day.
He put out something that was basically, I don't give a shit whether I have a job or not, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, go for it.
Yeah, he went for it.
He does.
Yeah, apparently, Schumer said he doesn't work for her, but that's not true. He does work for her.
She tweeted that out. She tweeted out that I'll read you the tweets. It said that Kurt doesn't...
But she was saddened and disappointed by his...
Well, we all are. It has nothing to do with what he said recently.
No, yeah, yeah.
It's, just with the way he's lived his life.
Yeah, or being trapped
in... We're all sad and disappointed in Kurt's life.
Or trapped, yeah, being trapped in an elevator with him. That's right. I am so sad. Kurt does not work for me. He is not a writer on my show. Please stop asking me about it. His words are not mine. That's what she tweeted out.
But he is a writer on the show.
I mean, that's what I thought.
We can wipe history clean. That's what we're all...
Is that what we're proving here?
Wait, are you trying to Chris Benoit, Kurt Metzger?
It's exactly it. He never existed.
I'm going to go into the exercise room. Family, follow me. Follow me into the exercise room.
Is that still not one of the greatest things that ever happened? I remember watching that Monday Night Raw live.
He killed his family?
Yeah, isn't that great?
Yeah, when they came out.
Three more Canadians down. No, when he, the first night, the news came that he died and it was a moment
of silence.
But it was not even a moment of silence. They did like a whole, like, all the guys were talking about him, like, interstitially on the show. And then the next day it came out that he, like, murder-suicide his whole family.
Yeah.
And then they had to go, it's like, yeah, never mind. Like,
yeah.
Forget all that.
That was just wrestling talk.
Yeah.
That was all fake wrestling talk.
Hey, our new studio, Ron, I don't know if you know this, but if you don't touch the computer for a while, you got to type in a whole code just to get back to the call screen.
That makes it easier.
Yeah.
That makes it easier. That's progress.
Also, turns out that's how you light Big J's fuse. You lock up a computer.
I didn't make the B capital, so it didn't work.
Fucking cool and easy.
Fantastic. Cool. Thank God I learned how to type.
Cool and easy Big J really goes 0 to 60 Soder when the fucking computer locked
Holy
up.
Holy shit. This thing. We got Christine's banished over to the Middle Earth over there.
Yeah, but she looks like she's running the Starship Enterprise.
Yeah.
Like, that's the coolest seat in the place.
She hates it over
hates
there.
It. She hates
you know
hate it.
I hated it more last time. I'm actually kind of enjoying it today because I have the two computers set up.
Christine, you need to make up your mind because we are almost fired Andy on Monday. Good show. I almost put him to pasture.
Today was going
to
be his last day.
Yeah. I was going to shave
Andy
him before
Fiore
we fired him.
Is not a writer for my show.
He is a friend of mine and I respect his beard. But his words are not mine.
His words are not my words. I gotta really go through Kurt's stuff. That's the thing. I really haven't come through Kurt's shit.
Go through some of the B-sides. That's where
But
Kurt
I mean,
really...
about this subject.
I mean, I think I've watched it, because I mean...
But am I crazy that Kurt's underlying thing is like...
Let's just go to the police.
This guy's... I don't think Kurt's arguing that the guy's even guilty. He's just saying, why are we figuring it out at UCB?
I think Kurt said some insensitive things, but overall, I think Kurt is making a good point that you just need to go to the cops, and I think he's just oversaying it to the point that people are like, it sounds like harassment.
I mean, you're dealing with a guy who, if you leave him alone for 5 minutes, will start having a discussion with himself. And not just in his head, like inner dialogue. I mean mouth moving.
Yeah.
No sound coming out. And I've caught him doing that in our friendship, I'm going to say 2,000 times.
Yeah.
Can I say this? The plastic bag with all of his personal things in it?
Yeah, that's the Young Attell starter kit.
That's the oddest. But how many times last night we're doing Comedy 101, he rings the bell, and he gets into a ramble, and I'm like, uh-oh, we're in some fucking weird place here. We're not going to be able to pull out. And then it ends up being hysterical.
Oh, yeah.
He's different.
No, he is. His mind works. I said him and Dave Attell are two people who I say in my life, who their mind works, like you can't even, you couldn't take a joke from them because it's from their minds. Kurt, you know, will call me. That's what I think is cool about someone who's a writer. People who are...
he's not a writer. I heard that from Amy.
But people who are like consummate writers like that, they really do, they don't mind taking writing help. That's why I have a hard time doing any kind of roast stuff or where you have to write for it.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't want to take any help, and a lot of times they give you 5 seconds to do it, like that Comedy Knockout or At Midnight. You have to like write so quick in that day, and I don't like help.
Well, guys like Kurt and guys like Attell and guys like Vecchione, they're very like they work together a lot.
No, but not even that. But I'm saying Kurt over the years has called me 100 times to be like, hey, I got this premise, like help me out with a punchline for it, and I will. But when he says the premise, you're like, what? He's like, you know, the black mamba snake can get up on its top of its tail to actually bite you in the face. So I wrote this. I'm like, what?
Yeah. Why are
like,
you?
That sounds like a light car discussion more than a stage bit, but it ends up being like fucking brilliant. So
his
mind does work different.
Are they also quoting Che? Mm-hmm.
And what?
Che's a bad guy too.
Right.
Yeah. He's a new bad guy.
He's
Variety?
A bad guy like Kurt. Yeah.
I texted Che that him and Kurt need to start a tag team called the Dong Boys.
Yeah. And well, Che is also a guy. See, Che said this before. He goes, he doesn't think that, you know, Twitter is real. It's all fake. So you can say whatever you want, but these guys forget that these fucking major corporations will break in a heartbeat.
Yeah, and they also listen because that's like their fucking research.
Yeah, they have nothing else,
guys. It's trending. Like that's set in an office now with like actual levity. Like, guys, hold on. I know you want to knock it. Yeah, it's moon boots for your asshole, but it's trending. And they're like, oh.
But isn't even like being in this, like I said, and Christine's used the term a bunch, and she's like trivializing rape in the sense that, I mean, Michael Che is saying the thing, like the idea that at the beginning is, you know, it's like you raped someone, like, no more comedy clubs for you. Like, shouldn't there be a stiffer... Like, the fact that it's even being argued on this minor level is so stupid. Like, hey, if he's a rapist, he cannot come over for dinner. I don't care how close of a friend he is.
And I think it's kind of important that Che and Kurt didn't rape anyone. You know what I mean? Like, we could disagree with them, but they didn't rape someone.
Yeah.
He's raping my eyes with his tweets.
Oh, good point. He's taking my time for talking about this. Although it's like that old Patrice joke.
I did see what Kurt said today, that what you are doing is worse than rape. He said to the people out
to them? Oh.
Yeah. Well, that's where Kurt... That's what I love about Kurt. He goes too far. He's like Rambo.
Yeah. It's when the eyebrows... When the eyebrows keep growing, when they touch in the middle is when he turns full-blown evil.
This is lightning bolts.
That's when the pure evil comes out. No, I mean,
you guys, it's happening.
What I find interesting about this is that when me and Kurt were walking after one of my shows in Montreal, we were walking together to another gig, and he said he was really concerned about me for my joke where I used the word tranny. And the joke is about people getting upset with the word.
Yeah.
But he's like, man, you just might want to change. Like, I think I'm telling you, like, people are looking for those hot button words to just, like, jump on and make a whole thing about. It's the temperature right now. You can't walk the line like that. And I'm like, Kurt, I've never had a complaint. Everyone seems fine. I kind of explain it. I almost disclaimer it while I'm shitting on it and the whole thing. No. I was telling you, man, I would just, all right, dude, do what you want to do. But I say, be careful. And then it's like, you know, 2 weeks later, he's like,
he's
ingrained in like a major like thing. And people are calling him all kinds of stuff, I assume.
Kurt reminds me of one of those guys that's like a former gang member that counsels young kids. And he's like, these streets ain't the way to go. And you're like, hey, where's Mr. Timothy? He's like, he killed 3 people. And you're like, oh my God.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
He was ordained online.
We were talking about
killed people.
We were talking about Craig Elo today. We said that Craig Elo from the Cavs. said that his last name sounded like a gang member, Elo. So we just kept going, 225 Street Elos.
All right, I got to go, boys. I'm getting some free food.
All right.
So good to see you.
Way to come here and stir up a good rape talk.
Thanks. And by the way, and then after that, I'm going to a candlelight vigil. But thank you again for last night. You're amazing,
thank
buddy.
Thank you, Ron. Thanks for having me. That show.
So fun.
Comedy 101, you're going to play it on Friday?
At the first. I think on Friday we found out we went 40 minutes over.
Yeah.
So we got to cut out, like I said, we're getting rid of all Kurt's stuff.
It was me, Kurt, and Sal Volcano, and it was just like...
So much fun. I did it with
three people. We had a good rhythm.
I did mine with Voss, List, and Lewis.
Yeah. Did a girl show her butthole on your show?
No, but Lewis had a really good zing.
Oh, well, that's big news, too.
Yeah, so there you go.
Both things are big news.
That's see you guys. Ball.
Bye, Ronnie.
Bye,
B.
Ron.
Ron Bennington. This will not happen again for another 2 months. I promise you that. Jacob always gets the most nervous when our guests go to leave.
Oh, God. Yeah. Oh, geez.
Can I walk you to the door?
You want to see me do some push-ups? Hey, me do a kip-up?
Hey, you know, everything they said was just tongue-in-cheek.
Jacob, true
are you
going to
melt down when Nikki comes in here?
I love Nikki.
Whoa.
Oh, Jesus, don't say it all
as
fucking...
someone that used to date her, bro?
But I told you every time...
I love her so much.
I think I've worked with her two or three times... Off the air, she just brings up Zac Efron.
Will you kip
every
up?
Time.
Will you kip up? Will you kip up for Nikki?
Yeah, come on. She's 6 foot tall.
Will you kip up for Nikki?
Whatever.
Her boyfriend's gorgeous, too.
Is she six foot tall?
I'm not going to kip up.
Will you kip up?
She's tall.
Will you kip up?
I don't know if she's six.
If she says it all,
will you
kip up for Nikki? You're fucking full of it. You will. I want to take a break right now because you've upset me.
I don't want to take a break. I want to shame you.
Shame! Shame.
You know what you just did in this culture? You just raped our idea.
You did.
You happy?
You took it.
I'm taking the Twitter on the break.
Are you going to go tweet?
Jacob is no producer of mine.
We'll be right back. It's The Bonfire.
Summer's flying, everybody. And I want to make sure I'm enjoying it to the fullest. And that's why I care about getting my best quality sleep so much. How much are you finding at your age now, Soder, that sleep is super important?
I mean, it's... as important as having a balanced diet.
I never cared when I was a kid so
me
much
neither.
About sleeping. I didn't care about sleeping in, but I didn't care about like
good
where
sleep.
Or yeah, not at all. And now as an adult, I need it so much, especially with our crazy schedules. And that's why I love my Sleep Number bed. To be your best during the day, you can't afford a mediocre night's sleep, but you can afford a Sleep Number bed. My Sleep Number setting, 45, holding strong at that, Sodage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the Sleep Number
I'm
bed.
I'm back up to 40.
Are you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what you were saying before was just insanity. The Sleep Number bed lets me choose my ideal firmness, and I get to change it. And each side adjusts, making it perfect for me to sleep on my side and Christine to be far, far away, sunken in. With optional Sleep IQ technology, it tracks your sleep so you know what to adjust for the best quality sleep, like your Sleep Number setting. In fact, according to Sleep IQ Research, which there's a team of those,
yeah.
Sleep IQ researchers, people who adjust their sleep numbers... settings are 58% more likely to have improved sleep quality. And that's what I'm jumping all over the board with that thing. My Sleep Number setting again, 45. A Queen Sleep Number mattress with Sleep IQ technology starts at only $1,099.98. It's a great value. No better sleep. Sleep Number beds and Sleep IQ technology are only available at any of the 475 Sleep Number stores nationwide. Find one near you by going to sleepnumber.com and be sure to tell them what, Danny?
That Jay and Dan from the Bonfire sent you.
That's too wordy.
That is very wordy.
Yeah, I'm a happy camper.
And now back to the Bonfire with Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Old Dirty Wednesdays.
All day.
Dirt McGirt, that's my motherfucking... You know why he was so great and grimy?
Yeah.
Listen what the song does. At one point, the music stops, and there's a girl just starts bitching at him, and he starts singing Somewhere Over the Rainbow. It's one of my favorite things ever.
ODB was like... he was a guy that I didn't appreciate until he was already dead, and...
Oh, yeah, wait. Right here. Listen. Why does he even know that?
It's great.
Danny.
Hey.
Are you getting ready to go to Vermont, buddy?
Yeah.
How excited are you?
Yeah.
The Vermont Comedy Club. Look out for Dan Soder. Burlington, Vermont, this Friday, August 19th and Saturday, August 20th. Get your tickets at dansoder.com. And don't forget, not special. Still available.
iTunes, several other digital platforms, as well as use people still going strong and they, on the tube.
On the tube. They go to iTunes and get Big J Oakerson special live at Webster Hall, and he's going to be at the Comedy Zone in Greenville, South Carolina. Tomorrow through Saturday, August 20th. Get tickets at BigJComedy.com. And then also, don't forget to follow us at the Bonfire SXM, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat.
Facebook, the Bonfire.
And SXM. Facebook. And speaking of Facebook, Jacob brought up a good point. We got into it talking about Kurt Metzger and Amy Schumer and all that stuff. And we really didn't give a backstory of what was happening. But a comic in New York got accused of... Well, he got banned from UCB because they said... That he
no official accusations.
No official accusations.
Just social media shit.
But UCB, I believe, released an internal memo saying that this comedian was banned because he had raped multiple women. And then it went on Facebook, and I remember it came out, and I was like, "What happened?" And then people showed it, and I was like, "Man, what a piece of shit!" And so it's like it's easy to get caught up in. But then Kurt took the stance of, "This is a lynch mob." Facebook is making all the judgments. They should go to the cops, which is something that Michael Che also said. And then now people were going to Amy to basically denounce Kurt. And
then she did it.
And she did it.
She basically denounced him.
And that was what we were talking about with Ron Bennington, is that Kurt has been denounced by... what is it? What do they say when there's like a bombing? And they're always like, President Obama has condemned. It's condemned. So she's condemned. Is it? Has Amy
excommunicated?
I don't think so. I mean, Kurt's going to obviously talk about it on his show, and he knows more. I mean, we're saying...
I think he's talking about it about 8 p.m. tonight.
Yeah, I heard 8:15, so just in case we go long.
Oh, yeah. It's he starts talking about it about 8:15.
And by the way, this is all just press for serious.
I don't even know if we're doing the show tonight, to be honest with you.
Yeah. You know what? I'd probably just check for it on demand. I'd just ride this one out.
Yeah.
Just ride this episode out. We got Nikki Glaser on.
You don't want to catch it live. We're going to be singing songs.
We're going to be singing songs. We're going to be talking about a man and his dog with Nikki Glaser.
Which we were right in the middle of watching that first episode.
We were watching.
He's getting ready to throw some performer under the bus, you could hear. By the way, he did say, if you recall, the word... We might back up here like a couple seconds in this video because... He goes, Jimmy Walker and blah, blah, blah. Jimmy Walker.
So we're obsessed with this club owner in Kansas City.
Craig Glazer,
where Jay just worked, and Nikki Glazer started there. But this guy, you know, it's what happens when you just chase pussy your whole life and not a family. Oh, okay. It's ODB.
What's happening? Is that... No, that was Craig Glazer rapping ODB?
yeah.
$20 to get in, so he went to our ATM.
Why are you so far up?
Yeah, go back. We're gonna watch this video. This is just a taste, and then I'm gonna
be there because they couldn't get work anywhere, and they would open and feature. They weren't even headliners yet for the most part. But one time we had Lewis Blackfin when his career took off, and I heard him tell the story on either Howard Stern or The Tonight Show. It's gonna happen. Stanford and Sons. A guy came in to go to our dance club. We had the nation's busiest hip hop dance club.
The nation's
next to a restaurant upstairs or a comedy club, and Lou was up there doing comedy. At that time, he was on The Daily Show. He was just getting to be a star. And a guy tried to come in and go to the comedy studio, the dance club, and he didn't have the $20 to get in. So he went to our ATM, and he tried to put his card in. It didn't work, and he kicked the machine. So the doorman kicked him out. He went to his car and got his gun. He had a revolver, and you've heard a drive-by. So he drove by the front of Stanford's. Boom, boom, boom. Shot through the window. Lewis Black was coming down the stairs with Brian Burgess, our manager. Brian Burgess is kind of better known for having a brother named Mitchell Burgess who wrote a TV show you might have heard of called The Sopranos. So Brian, the window exploded, and Lewis thought it was like a bomb. And Brian Burgess, the manager, covered Lewis Black. And Lewis went, "Oh my God, were those gunshots?" And Burgess went, "Lou, don't worry. They were trying to kill Craig."
That's like a guy that you get trapped at a barbecue with, and you're like, I'm going to go home.
Wait, before you go, here, first of all, take some macaroni salad to go. You got too much.
Have you tried one of my burgers?
Second of all, took 3 bullets back in the late 80s. I was capo of the mafia.
They wrote Rambo about me. My real name.
I'm actually in the middle of a lawsuit right now because they stole the rights to my autobiography and made them film Rambo.
And then my daughter was
taken and I had to go find her.
You don't have a daughter.
You may have noticed I was gone for a couple of years. That's when my daughter was taken, and I had to go over to Belfast to solve all these problems in a very, very fast and yet sleek Mini Cooper.
And the dogs were there. So we'll get back to that. Just because Nikki started at that club, that fucking blows me away.
It's great.
Are my peas popping, Lou? How do you feel about that?
No, I think your peas are okay.
My peas are pool.
It's all about Mike. It's all about Mike technique.
Oh, this motherfucker wants to call me out and go from the side. Like
I know
this.
You were in radio for a number of years.
You want me to side broadcast?
But you should give it, what is that, 3 or 4 inches?
And you should give yourself 5 inches from me at all times. Cause I'm about
I feel
to punch
like if
you
I do
the
that,
face.
You can't hear me very well.
Well, that's what Lou's here for.
I'm always on it.
Thanks, Lou.
I am the audience.
Thanks, Lou. You're right here. That means you're very comfortable. Not like Christine, who we threw over in fucking shitbox corner.
Wow, what a great audience. Okay, hey, Shelby. Just people are coming through these hallways. I love these new studios, but I feel like an executive.
I want some kind of covering on these stupid glass walls we live in. What it sounds like a proverbial thing I'm saying, though. I just want to put some curtains up on the glass walls of my life.
Jay hit his artistic streak.
Hey, guys, I got to get out of here. I got to write a poem.
Jay's kind of difficult to work with.
Why are we the only one that has no curtains outside of it?
Jacob, is it so everyone can watch you do kip-ups?
That's exactly why. Oh, put in for curtains.
Yeah, they'll do it, right?
I say we start a full-out war with Entertainment Weekly.
I'm fucking so over Entertainment Weekly.
They're spilling
coffee. We came in, Jacob's Lysol wiping, like the very lady he wooed yesterday with fucking kip-ups.
He did not.
Now he's doing her job.
I hate to break it to you, but Jacob got beat by a can of garbage in wooing that woman.
Who, Kip? Kip Patat?
Kip Patat. That woman walked in and would rather deal with a fucking bag of garbage than Jacob.
She just didn't know.
She knew. She
thought when a white man calls you in, it's to change the garbage. But I was being more progressive than that, and I was like, watch Jacob do a kip up.
Now wait a minute. She walked in and she saw Jacob do the kip up and she's like, no,
he's not as good as I thought we're gonna be.
It'd be funny if she just had like a heavy Jersey accent. She's like, no thanks, bro.
Yeah,
I'm good.
Yeah, thanks, but no thanks.
Yeah, you little boy can jump up. Cool. I gotta collect the trash.
No offense, you seem like a good guy and all.
Yeah,
but I got a job to do.
Are you 100% Italian? Italian?
You Italian?
Video games might rip us apart, but what always brings us together
is a good Italian accent. And we gotta start figuring out, fellas. I hate to have the off-air stuff on air. Lou sends me this awesome list every couple weeks of people coming in, and we always say we'll come in early for the things to do interviews. Whenever we go, but did you see the last list?
Alan Thick.
Alan Thick, sure, that's great. But more importantly, Angela.
Judith Light.
Judith Light's coming in, and we have no access.
Oh, man.
Lou said you stopped responding to those things. I go, I always tell you who we wanted, and they never want to come in at 6 p.m.
Yeah, the first 3 months we worked here, we were so excited about all of it, and then nothing happened.
I mean, 6 months ago, I'd have been like, hey, Justin Bieber's probably going to come in on Sunday. We'll go in early Sunday. But yeah, I'd love to do Judith. Angela? The problem is, what we want to do with like an Angela is very short. We want like 15 minutes with her to do this stuff, maybe 20, and like to have everyone's day uproot to come in and do a 20-minute interview. I worry about that being
a
thing.
Now, my question is, do we have the juice to get the dancer in here with Angela?
Oh, together.
A reunion.
And we'll make him reenact the scene. Or we'll
the scene in the shower.
Or we should film a scene where we show them the shower scene, but it's me and you.
Yeah, we should go to the house in Connecticut. They filmed it.
The Micellis.
Yeah, dude, if we could totally do that
Angela,
shower
scene. I bet Tony Danza has no sense of humor about himself. I guarantee it.
Someone tweeted a picture recently of him at like Gotham Comedy Club. He was like out.
Yes, because he's good friends with Sebastian Maniscalco.
Is he really?
Yeah, they were on a pilot together that didn't go.
That's so funny.
Yeah.
You must be embarrassed.
We talking about embarrassed. Why? Because I'm a fucking 50-year-old cleaning man for Angela?
We can do it. I think we can bring him back.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
Should we do it? This is it. Should we do the reunion scene? And it's not her in the shower. It's her in the tub.
No, but she stands up.
Oh, look at that. There's nothing better in the 80s than a hot girl in a gold necklace.
Yeah, with huge headphones.
Yeah, which she could probably die from.
What a good scene.
And then here he goes.
Was this enough to pump off to when you were younger?
Yep.
Was it?
Yeah, right here. By the way, he's in there.
That's actually her. She had good stems.
What kind of bathroom is that? Why is he going into her bedroom? I mean...
Hi. Holy smoke.
She's become such an old lesbian-looking lady.
I mean, I wouldn't say that to her if we're trying to get her.
She's not listening and deciding what show she's going to come on.
I think that's... I've heard that's how she works.
I will not do a show I do not listen to.
I need to be informed.
Somebody takes the time on YouTube. This is amazing. This video is called Tony and Angela's Top 10 Moments. Someone takes the time for that. That's what I found out with the video games, by the way. You can get, like, next year's NBA... roster already. It's not going to be the official one.
Oh, well, dude, I used to do that with NCAA college football back on PlayStation 2. There was the ability, this kid that I went to college with, I'd bring him my memory card for NCAA college football, and then he'd bring it back to me with all the names and correct stats of every college player on the game. Full first name and last name. Because you couldn't do that, obviously, because of the NCAA rules.
That's fucking bonkers.
Dude, this kid, Josh, I would always find him. Because NCAA college football, which, by the way, is a much superior video game football-wise to Madden. And
what?
Yeah, it's the best.
What?
It got killed off because of the O'Banion twins.
What?
Yeah. NCAA college football was way better game than that. Yes, it is. 100% better.
College sports stink.
You stink. NCAA college football was the greatest video game for football ever.
Merkface, college sports?
College basketball, far superior to the NBA, in my opinion.
What?
March Madness tournament is maybe the greatest tournament of all sports.
But NCAA college football from EA Sports was the greatest video game for football ever.
You went to college. Did you go to college, Merkface?
Villanova, 2016 national champ.
Fucking nerds. That explains it all.
No, it doesn't, because I would have liked
it. Lou, did you go to college?
I didn't graduate.
Do you care about college sports?
No.
You see?
That's the only one, though.
But you like pro sports, right?
If Lou's technical school was on the video game, he would like them.
Lou, he went to one of those schools where in eighth grade you got to leave half day to go do like heating and cooling work.
I went from broadcasting, you jerk off.
He learned refrigeration at Star Tech Institute.
Yeah, Lou looks like there was mandatory smoke breaks at his college.
I'm not a painter. I'm not a mechanic.
Yeah, Lou looks like you got to bring your own welder's mask.
I went to college for radio, douchebags.
Sure you did.
Yeah, me and Professor Dennis are going outside to catch a butt. Me and Denny.
He's got cools. That's why he's my favorite professor.
Cut it out. I'm living my dream right now. This is what I went to school for.
I got my bachelor's in soldering. Yeah, but NCAA college football, they killed it because the O'Banion twins' case, your computer shut off again, and it makes me happy every time it does. But they had to pull the game, and then this was fucked up, the national championship.
Because it became a thing of, like, they weren't getting paid or whatever, right?
Yeah, but they would put the kids, they would put all the college athletes in as, like, number 6, number 16, and then that's why when I had a PlayStation 2, I'd give them my memory card and I'd get all the names. Then when you can go online, then it became super easy to do, when, like, Xbox 360 was online.
My point saying is just that I can't believe someone takes the fucking time to go through, you know, 29, 30 teams and make sure all the new rookies and all the trades up to date have happened.
Yeah, dude. What was crazy about it is I remember...
That's a lot of fucking time. And then to go, if I did that, I'd also be like, I'm keeping this for my fucking self because fuck the world. Why would I have to go through all that and give it to somebody else? They just give it to you.
You're a selfish man. Remember when we played at WWE 2K13?
Exactly. Yeah, that was the best. Road Warriors and all
those created former wrestlers. Someone goes through and does all their move sets too, that's a fucking lot of time.
I'm not even taking this call because it's just a ridiculous statement. Andrew in Texas, NFL Blitz is the best football game ever.
Well, he clearly smokes methamphetamine.
He doesn't like, I'm all, you know what, that's, look, it's not.
It's not terrible.
It's a ridiculous statement.
Well, I'll tell you this. It's a fun arcade game.
Exactly. It's not a... when I play sports games, I'm all about simulation.
Well, here's the thing.
I don't care about digging in too much. I mean simulation of a real game, whereas, like, I'm trying to get my star player, like, a good line. You know what I mean? I want him to get a decent amount of points. I try to get my point guard to get a lot of assists, like I play, you know what I mean?
That's why NCAA college football was the best, because you could do 20 years of a dynasty and just recruit And you just
keep... See, I can't do that. I can't get away from what's currently happening.
No, so you got to let go beyond your mind.
No.
A world imagination.
Come with me, and you'll see. But Blitz was just like an arcade game. It's kind of like that game Baseball Stars, Nintendo. They were all fun.
Yeah, I mean, Andrew sounds like he plays video games and just button mashes when he fights.
Yeah, he's playing like NBA, he's playing like NBA Jams.
Yeah, I like the sweet science.
Yeah,
I like
me too.
I like to flick a jab out there.
But then also not too much the other way. When people overthink their plays and set up hot routes and all that shit on Madden,
I get furious all day, and it's why I'm a superior Madden player to you.
You say you're a superior Madden player. Uh-huh. You were using the fucking best team in the game at one point.
San Francisco 49ers.
A couple years ago? Yes, they made them the Super Bowl San Francisco 49ers. That was the last time me and you played.
You know what? Next time we play, next week, when this game comes out, when this motherfucking game comes out, Eagles-Niners, rosters just straight up.
All white guys.
All white guys, just like our
NBA game.
Our Dayton Round Ball Classic. Dude, it's so crusty.
It is crusty.
We were playing Arvydas Sabonis versus Kurt Rambis.
People agree with you. Yeah. DJ North Dakota says the NCAA is the best game ever. Wayne in Charlotte says college games way better.
See?
Now, Nick in San Diego says games are too simulated now. It's not fun. And he's right. He is right about that.
I don't know.
If you do all the stuff, they still give you the opportunity to, like, just play the fucking game.
Yes.
But there is so much shit in there now that you could possibly do. It's pretty ridiculous.
Well, Nate Bargatze used to have that great joke about Madden. He's like, I didn't go to college. Why am I setting prices at a stadium?
Yeah, all that stuff's ridiculous. Like setting hot dog prices.
But I like the recruiting, and I like.
You want to do that? You want to set hot dog prices,
dude?
But you don't mind bringing in a fictitious player?
Not when I'm running a dynasty at the University of Arizona or Colorado.
The fictitious player bothers me.
Well, when I make the University of Colorado a powerhouse in football.
I've never done the thing where you make yourself.
Oh,
the fucking nerve.
I used to love
making yourself. Now, here's the thing. In the fighting games, I do it.
Well, then why is that? The nerve.
Because you make yourself the quarterback for the fucking team.
No, I make myself an outside linebacker and I set sack records.
That's just dumb.
You're dumb.
You're so dumb.
You're dumb. You're just mad that I'd come off the line and just fucking.
Although back in the NBA Live days, I would set up.
Guys, my friends. My stepdad's here. Oh, damn it!
I missed him. I would absolutely make all of my friends, and I was the center.
Dad,
but I was a kid.
How old?
The age you're supposed to be playing video games.
How old?
Oh, 16, 17.
Okay.
18, 19.
Yeah, I used to do that on NBA Live.
Last year?
A week ago.
Dan, you're my small forward.
I'm like, why am I not your power forward? Who do you got taller than me? Metzger? You better pull him off your team just like Amy did.
Oh, shit. Mike in Long Island wants to know the best wrestling game ever. You're going to say the N64 one.
N64 No Mercy.
I'm always going to say it was that 2K13.
Oh man, that was so much fun. I'll tell you this. Let me give you this credit. Modern generation wrestling games, WWE 2K13.
Was it 14 or 13? It may have been 14.
It was the one with The Rock on the cover. With The Rock and Daniel Bryan on the cover.
Was it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I want to say it was 2013.
It says 30 years of WrestleMania on it.
So yeah, I mean it's
that one. It was so fucking
2K13.
Damn, we had a good time playing. That was sort of the genesis of Bonfire.
Yeah, that game. By the way, we were gonna do our podcasts. We did 10 episodes and we just never released them. But we would do podcasts and cut them short so we could play Royal Rumbles.
Yeah, that's a true story.
Christine was there. Remember when we went to Sandwich King? Mm-hmm. And you guys brought me all that sweet sarsaparilla?
That's how we had the lure Christine, and we have to tell her that we'll get Sandwich King. And then me and you can play our video games.
She is not the kind of
girlfriend that dives into the video game, by the way. She doesn't get there like...
But do you remember what she said to you that was so emasculating when you were going to come over?
Oh, is there another thing? Please go. Tell me.
No, but do you remember that when you were coming over and you go, yeah, and you and Dan can play your wrestling. And you're like, all right, Christine. You got mad in front of me. You're like, okay, Christine. You make it act like we're going to fuck. And you're like, might as well. That was so great. I remember exactly where you were. You were right in my kitchen over the fucking kitchen hump.
You guys can do your wrestling.
You guys can go play your wrestling. I was like, oof, that stung.
Go smoke your pot.
Yeah, go smoke your pot. That's what my ex-girlfriend said. She goes, I think you have a dependency on pot. I was like, yeah, you're just learning that? We were together for 2 years. It's how I operate.
I think you need it. Yeah.
Yeah. Are you saying it's a weakness?
I think you need it more than you need me.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, if we're just coming to this, we have a lot of catching up to do.
NBA 2K5 is the best game ever?
Well, I mean, now you're going best game ever. This is too out there.
This says 2K5.
Because Fight Night Round 2 is clearly the best sports game.
I think Murkface wrote that wrong, and it's 2K15.
Well, we all know Murkface went to Villanova, and he's bragging about it.
Is it 2K15, Murkface, or 2K5?
Do you want to ask Dennis?
Yeah.
Dennis, this is you, Dennis!
Dennis, this is you!
Yay!
What's up, buddy?
Yeah, I meant the NFL 2K, whatever the 2K was the last NFL game.
Oh, no! You're talking about when the NFL did, when it wasn't Madden.
But Sega, for a minute.
Yeah, Sega did the NBA. There was one, he's right, 2K5
was pretty good.
But
it's also NFL, and Murkface put NBA.
Because Murkface is a fucking idiot.
But now I don't take his opinion at all on being into the college sports. He's just trying to nuzzle up to you. He doesn't know anything about sports.
College sports games.
Andy, shut up. You're losing my argument for me. Dennis, I agree with you that NFL 2K5, and this is, I believe, for Dreamcast?
Oh, yeah.
That was Xbox, regular Xbox.
Regular Xbox. Okay. I think it's a great football game, but it's not as good as NCAA college football. That was just a way more fun game. You could get crusty matchups. The toilet bowls.
You know, Dreamcast had the NBA game where the players were the size of full-size Jacobs. I mean, on the screen, they were huge on a TV screen.
Huge.
Yeah, they were biggish. Remember that?
Also, they had one of the first UFC games.
Did they?
Yeah. Dreamcast? They had a great UFC game.
Was that the shortest lived? What was the shortest lived video game system? Maybe the Jaguar?
What about the GameCube?
GameCube stuck around for a bit.
You're right. Jaguar. Neo Geo was awesome, though.
Neo Geo had the one where you could bring it to the arcade and home.
Yeah. Neo Geo started in the arcades. That was like War of Worlds and like...
It was like four games in it or something.
Yeah, the Heroes. What is it? Lost Hero? And then Rampage was on it. Yeah, Neo Geo is great. But I'm trying to think of the shortest lived...
Sega CD.
It had to be a Dreamcast. Dreamcast was way too far ahead of its
time. No, I think Sega CD was shorter lived than Dreamcast because...
Even the really throwback ones aren't short-lived because they were around for a while, like Coleco, which stunk.
Jaguar died quick.
Jaguar came out.
Do you remember the Nintendo VR, the first virtual reality?
Yeah, it was black and red.
Yeah.
Yeah, Nintendo. It was like a tank game. It fucking sucked.
Yeah, it's horrible.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dennis.
You have a good one,
Dennis. When I was...
Can I say one thing? Fuck you, Dennis.
When I was a...
not that, Dennis.
I told a story before. I'm pretty sure when I was a kid, just being so impatient to get my Nintendo that I just got the Atari 7800.
I mean, that was...
I can say good about that system was it had a real heavy joystick piece with it. Yeah. The Nintendo 7800. You bring that up, Christine, the joystick with a long cord. And it was a pretty sturdy looking system. It was a real thick box. And it looked like... And then you could just fucking... And when I would like lose at like Jordan versus Bird or Dr. J versus Bird, I would just, not that one. That's not the 7800. 7200.
Hey, you know what's going on?
I would just fucking beat the system with the thing so hard.
You would
hard.
Hit the system with the controller?
Yeah. I'd whip it down. There. No, down. Go down.
Hey, you know what I like about Murkface?
There's the controller. There's the controller and the system. I just saw it. What's going on here?
I think you should be closer to us when you're answering.
Third row, second from the end. No, second from the other end. I'm sorry. That's the controller.
And you just beat the shit out of it?
Dude, I would just wail.
It looks like a it looks like a controller for our sleep number beds.
It does. But I would take that by the cord and just whip down like thunder on machine. The machine was beat up bad.
I punch my coffee table. What do you punch when you get angry at video games? Because we both, let's not kid each other.
I'll slap my leather ottoman, which is a good one because it gets a good like you get a really good slap sound.
Yeah, I punch down on my coffee table and I have to do it on the corner over the leg of the table or else there'd be some fucking real shit.
I started doing God of War 3 remastered.
Yeah, great.
On PS4. But they remastered, but one of the problems of the game, when you die, sends you back too far. It's a pet peeve of mine with video games.
So you're mad?
And when you lose, those kind of things stir you up.
Yeah. Let's take a break because we got a guest.
Oh, okay. I guess I'll just serve my story up my own dick hole.
No, because we're talking about punching stuff and then Jacob's all freaking out. Don't do this. Don't do this before our guest. Is this because we're going to try to woo our guest?
It's the bonfire.
Don't be mad at me, buddy. Oh, this is fun. Discover great stories performed by talented actors and narrators, audiobooks from Audible, an Amazon company. Audible provides an unmatched selection of bestsellers, new releases, sci-fis, mysteries, classics, and more. Start with a free audiobook by going to audible.com/serious. Use your smartphone or tablet along with the Audible app. You can escape with a story anywhere, on your commute, doing chores in the car, or on the go. And that means you've got
somebody's
time.
Somebody's peacocking for our guests.
And that means you've got time to make the books look. Make the book. You, Jay! You stop me!
John.
We've got great authors at Audible, like John Grisham, Stephen King, Harry Potter. He's not an author. Game of Thrones. Whatever your interest.
Harry Potter?
It's Harry Potter. You'll
my
find
favorite
it.
Author?
You'll find it at Audible. So your next dinner prep could also be a spine-tingling thriller. Your next workout, a breathless adventure. Hear it for yourself. Start a 30-day trial, and your first audiobook is on us. Go to audible.com/serious. I'll do it better next time.
Hey, this is Nikki Glaser, and you're listening to The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder. I've watched one of these men cry.
Fucking lie. Your ass don't want to get
ODB
Welcome
Wednesday.
Welcome back to The Bonfire.
ODB Wednesday all day.
ODB boy. Wednesday, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95, Big J. Oakerson, Dan Soder. Jacob, what just happened
our
there?
Our guest today, Nikki Glaser from the show Not Safe on Comedy Central.
Hello.
And she came into the studio, asked something to drink, and you asked for
a bottle of water.
I said a bottle of sparkling water or seltzer.
Oh, you did?
Oh. I did.
Oh, this wasn't that impressive.
Okay. I
thought you just said water.
Me too.
And then changed your mind that
no,
you wanted
I did.
A Schweppes.
I thought we were all going to lie and say that I asked for Schweppes.
Yeah, but here's the thing that happened. In between times, he brought in a real Schweppes.
I think someone told him.
Did someone tell you to get a Schweppes?
To get a Schweppes.
No, I just thought maybe...
I love that.
Wow.
You gave me a
seltzer.
Okay, sorry. I thought we were lying.
Oh, no.
No, I asked for a bottle of water, and you brought me exactly what I wanted when I didn't even know I wanted it until I saw that Jay had a can.
Next question for my friend Jacob is, how big and scary is your boyfriend, and can he do a kip-up?
Can your boyfriend do a kip-up?
No, definitely not.
Jacob?
Dan said he's a model.
I said he's gorgeous.
He's gorgeous. But he can't do it. No, his shoulder's all fucked up.
So that's the only reason why.
Is that your reason why?
Is your shoulder all fucked up?
That's my reason. My bum shoulder.
Yeah, me too.
You can do one, Jay. I still think you can, and
I
should.
I do also.
What about me, motherfucker?
Both of you. I want to see you do it.
No, you can do it. You do it.
Do it.
She wants to see
please.
It so bad.
Please.
I haven't seen one since, like, fourth grade.
What was his name?
Willie Donald.
Willie Donald. Real names are always funny.
Yeah.
Can you ask him all, like, Marilyn Monroe? Like, could you please?
Please do it.
Please do it.
Look at him pick his jacket off.
Yes.
No more of that, Nikki. I don't want him. He can't do a kip with a boner. It's impossible.
Or
can he?
Or this might be Dan's science.
What if it projects him forward and he goes forward so far that that the dick holds him up like a kickstand? Forward.
All right, Jacob.
Oh my gosh,
this is impressive.
Time to shine.
This really is something. Never say die.
Yeah. That was awesome.
It brings me so much fucking joy.
That's a guy who gets a girl a Schweppes when she doesn't even know she wanted it.
So would
the
you
enemy
say
deserves no mercy?
Fear does not exist in this studio, does it? No, Jacob.
Would you, Nikki? Would Jacob be a Nikki Glaser approved bachelor after what he's done so far?
That was pretty impressive. Yes, absolutely.
There you Thank go. You got signed off.
Awesome. Yeah.
You're Nikki Glaser approved.
That's such a... it's so important when guys get girls water. I mean, after sex and any... Like, just make sure we're hydrated and you got both things.
Like what am I, fucking Gunga Din? Get
your own water. Yeah, I didn't know.
Equality.
No.
I got
gender
water.
Equality.
I got the water
nice
and I was passing and I said...
Maybe she wants a seltzer.
Oh, my God. So I am seriously touched.
That's all Rosie Perez wanted in White Men
Billy,
Can't Jump.
When I say that I'm thirsty, I don't want you to bring me a glass of water.
I want you to sympathize with me.
I want you to say I was thirsty, too.
I've
only heard impressions of that scene, and it's so funny.
My ex-girlfriend, we had that exact thing, and this is when I knew we were going to break up, because I go, oh, this is like the scene in White Men Can't Jump and Rosie Perez, and she's like, that's what you're equating it to? And I was like, yeah, this is over.
And you equating, I
equivalating?
Believe.
Shit. Did she say that? No, wait, she said that.
She said that.
You were just remembering it correctly.
Yeah.
Why are you equivalating it like that?
What is a quince?
Oh, man. Food to start with the letter Q.
Q. So we were talking about earlier, Jay was recently at Stanford and Sons in Kansas City, and I was saying how impressive it is that you started on the road and made it. Like, not a lot of people make it off the road and then can continue on.
Well, yeah, I mean...
What does that mean exactly?
Here's the thing. I think he means like road dogs don't often get off the road if they start in the Midwest as like, you know, Kansas City.
So were
road
you?
Dogs.
But I was saying, were you doing the road a ton before you settled in New York?
Yes.
You were. Okay. Yeah. I did feel everyone kind of starts somewhere else.
Oh, I mean, I started in Tucson.
Exactly. But I started in Kansas City. But I wasn't like, but I was doing the
road
a lot.
The road a lot.
Yeah, I was.
I would say you were made on the road. You were headlining on the road before you moved to a major city.
Well, I moved to LA right out of college, so no to that. But like before I moved to New York, I was like, I'm not going to do this until I'm a headliner.
Wow.
That Nikki opened for me at San Fran Punchline.
Yeah, and that was amazing.
And then she leapfrogged me like a parking meter.
You were so fucking funny. That was like one of those weekends where you work with someone and you're like, what am I doing?
Yeah.
You know where you have those? You were so good, man.
You know, thank you so much. You know what what's funny we've talked about with your bumpers you have for the show?
Oh, yeah.
You said it's been documented on the show that you and Soder dated briefly. But
hot minute.
You said that...
like a week.
One of them says that I've sexually disappointed one of these guys. And I was saying, and we're like, oh, I think all the rest.
Well, I think I wanted to say he sexually disappointed me, but I didn't want to be like.
Okay, so was you?
I can take it all.
I thought it might have been me you meant by that, in the sense that what you came back. It was years ago to like smoke in my room.
Oh yeah, we smoked in your room.
But
no.
But I was saying, but we just sat there, and I was like. This girl's not going to fuck me at all. I'm not aggressive enough to even be like, so...
I'm so happy you weren't. That would have been so weird.
I've been saying in the temperature of all the stuff going on, I'm happy that I'm skittish with girls
I give off really good, like, don't touch me vibes.
Yeah, you give
like,
great...
Even when I want someone to fuck me, I'm like, they have no idea.
None whatsoever.
I had to tell you.
Yeah, you had like a carrot with a mule.
I was just like, we were in a cab, and I was just like, I like you, I just need you to know that. And this is weird for me to hear you talk about your ex-girlfriend. And you were just like, okay, cool. And we just like had a weird cab ride.
You just hear the Queensboro Bridge.
I was like, why does this guy not kiss me when I say that?
Because I'm dumb.
Yeah, you were.
You had to spell it out.
And then,
remember all the hot chick that Pete brought home, my roommate?
Yes.
That was like the most fun part of our relationship was watching all the skanks
That was it. Yeah,
that
it was just
our
like hanging out on your couch after Seth of the Cellar and then laughing at Pete.
Yeah, my roommate who was like a former underwear model. Yeah. And he'd bring home all these curls.
I was trying to get to Pete.
Yeah. It makes sense.
It was the worst. He would come out with this, like, just like come out with his shirt off constantly.
All the time. One time I brought a girl home much after you, way after you. And then.
hours
after you. And I came home and he was on the couch in European cut underwear. And we walked in the door and I go, hey, why don't you throw a shirt on? I'm not losing this in the 12th hour. I've been funny the whole night and you just come in lounging around.
Have I told you with the, I don't know if I said on the show that the, like, needing it to be spelled out for you, like, not being aggressive at all. That was in Kansas City years ago. I was doing Stanford and Sons Comedy Club, and I went back with a waitress, really pretty girl, and did everything. Everything from playing her like garage band songs that I had on my thing and listening to music. I mean, till it was sun was out.
I get it.
I went into the bathroom at one point. I peed, and when I came out, she was under the covers, and I saw that her clothes were on the floor.
Yeah.
And I still was like, what do you want to do now? She goes, dude, I'm in your bed naked. Like, please already? And I'm like, oh, okay, yeah.
Are you just seeing how the mattress feels and the yeah. sheets against your skin? Feels pretty good.
Oh, you want me to stay in the other room?
I get it. I mean, because you want to be absolutely sure that yes. you're not going to be rejected, because that's the worst feeling in the world, to like lean in for a kiss and be like, no. You yeah. know, obviously. But... I for the first time, and so I would always get frustrated and just always be like, hey, can we make out? Like, I would always just say that to every single guy that I ever kissed, and it just wasn't working out. So this last time I refused and waited. It's hard to wait. And because I don't, yeah, it was just.
If you say it, 90% of the time, guys will, I mean, if not more
yeah,
than that.
I mean, yeah. like, I would wait until I'm very sure.
I believe you said, you better kiss me later, because we were watching Woody Allen's Annie Hall.
No, we watched Annie Hall, and in that movie, they yeah. go, let's just kiss right now to get it over with. Yeah. And at the end of the movie, I go, that's a good idea. Let's just do that, because what are we doing?
That was
and
smart.
Then we, yeah. That was the see Annie Hall. If you want to kiss a girl, see Annie Hall, and then use that line afterwards. Like, we should do that.
I had a similar story. Me and Christine watched Anal Invaders 14. And she was like, we should do that later.
You should probably roll over to your side. You should just do this, get it out of the way.
I was like,
you want to sit on my fingers now while we watch the movie? So afterwards, you're ready?
Do you want me to put on the space costume first, or just butt fuck you right now?
Because I am G2G.
Should we do Glazer videos first, or try to woo Nikki first?
Oh, no. We should do our videos first. We should close out. With wooing.
What is wooing?
Well, we'll see later.
Okay. Well, I'm just having fun talking.
We're going to try to win your heart through the glory of song. Just
all
one
right.
of us. Just, but you don't, not like real life, just but your bonfire boyfriend. You get to pick your boyfriend from the bonfire. Hmm.
Do you go Big back J? To the old standby? The thing you know and you've probably gotten bored
Jacob
of?
Jacob is out! Don't point at him! I will snap your neck.
Okay. All right.
But that's later.
That's fun. Yeah. Can't wait.
I want to see if
it's through song.
It's through song. You have to pick through song.
We picked two songs.
Dan, who are you dating now?
No one.
What's going on?
Nothing. Just getting shut down.
You've been broken up with. You broke up with that your long term girlfriend.
Yeah, that one.
A while
to LA
ago. Yeah.
A year ago. Jay and Christine watched that crumble.
Good news though. She's fucking Frank Thomas.
The Big Hurt, former first baseman for the Chicago White Sox. He was hitting on her aggressively while we were dating.
How are you for this year? How has it been?
It's good. I had another a wealthy girlfriend that dumped me.
Oh yeah, you told me about that one.
And then I got back with her, and then we broke up again.
She was pretty broken up at it, and then parasailing moments later made it okay again.
Yeah,
and parasailing
when
with
she was spelunking
Donald Trump's nephew.
Yeah, when she was eating caviar with Scott Wolf's cousin,
practicing her dressage.
Yeah, it was. but you started. The back to the original point. You started in St. Louis. And then would work like Kansas City.
I went to school in Kansas, Lawrence, and then I would go to Kansas City to like do open mics and stuff.
And that's where you'd go.
And then I would started. My first gig was at like the first time I worked, didn't get paid, but worked was at Sanford and Sons.
How was my set?
Hey, you got a great set. Maybe bring it back in the office. I'll go over it.
Oh,
I've worked with a lot of good comics.
Is.
Why is Justin Silver in there?
Someone did that. Brian Murray did that.
That's sweet. That's,
you want to talk about dogs?
Hey, you guys talking about dogs?
People who are weighing the dogs have that voice.
Hey, I'm back from L.A.
He keeps wanting me to go over to his house and see his yoga room.
Who?
Justin.
Really?
Wait, seriously?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
I
is
run
that
into
true?
Him all the time, and he's like, me and my girlfriend have this great yoga studio.
Oh, in L.A.
Yeah, in L.A.
They broke up.
Yeah, I know. And then he was like, still like, you know, you gotta come see it.
He did have a yoga room in his
yeah,
defense.
I believe
went out
it.
There. He did have a yoga room.
It.
That sounds
He's a great
like
guy.
The biggest ploy to get a girl over, though.
Oh, I bet it's great. But I'm sure it works. I mean, Justin's also a good-looking dude.
You know what I imagine?
He's good with dogs. Ugh.
He just opens the door. It's just an empty room. And he goes, that's my yoga room.
And this is where the magic happens.
Should we? Let's play Nikki a episode of A Man and
Let's
His
go
dog.
To six.
We just did six.
No, we just did five.
What?
This is six.
We did eight. We did eight? That was the final one?
No, this is six.
So I mentioned I own Stanford and Sons Comedy Club, one of the most famous comedy clubs in the world.
That couch.
And we're the oldest comedy club in the world. And I've run it since I was a kid. I know I look much younger.
Pause it. He contradicts himself every episode. He said we're the oldest comedy club in the world. Last episode, the one right before this.
He just watched it last hour.
We're the second oldest comedy club in the country.
He goes, the comedy store,
which is owned by Pauly Shore's mom, Mitzi. And I guess that's been 50 or some years. But,
she's a bimbo.
Anyway, she's a real bimbo. Dogs are here. Got a hand job in the Lotus on the way to Johnny Dare. Bims. Dog's there.
Oh, crap.
Junior, shut up. All right, I'm fucking this pig. Her son's waiting out in the car. He's picking
you
her up in a Hyundai.
You haven't used the N-word yet, so I'm not believing this impression.
He said to us, I swear to you, this is a quote. You remember this, Christine? This is a great quote. He goes, he was dating, I'm dating this black girl named Black Barbie. And, you know, she was just like, you hate, and he shows me a picture of her, of course. She's like, you don't like black people. He goes, well, we used to run this Westport Theater, the club here in Westport. He goes, we had the most, like, bumping nightclub in all of Kansas City. He goes, there'd be a line of niggas around the corner.
What the fuck?
Jesus H.
You just throw that in and you just do the version? Like,
he just was, he was his whole, the whole conversation was to say he was not, she said he was racist, she thought, and proving he wasn't.
Yeah, then he uses the bite-sized terms of racism.
So funny. It's cute. That's a cute name.
I'll take a couple.
Niggas lined up around the corner.
God damn it.
And then Jeff comes in, has the best of Jeff goes,
and what, here's how it's gonna go. The MC's gonna do fine.
And how much time are you doing? Like, even have to ask everyone
you're
again and again how
go
much
up
time.
And do 5 minutes. Everyone knows.
Don't listen to Jeff. He's out there talking about his 5 minutes nonsense.
I love when Craig opens the show.
Yeah.
Oh,
and does a quick 20 up top.
And he keeps telling you, by the way, he's like, luckily, he goes, well, sometimes the MC doesn't show up on time, and I got to go up there. He goes, luckily, I happen to be really funny, so it works out.
I feel like
and then one time, David Tell came on stage, and he's like, Craig, you've been up here for 40 minutes, and it's just like, you know, I didn't realize I was having such a good time, but it's like a natural thing.
Do you know, he and Donald Trump are like the same person.
Yeah, they just say crazy shit to get reactions.
I think he is a narcissist. Like, kind of a lying narcissist.
Oh, you mean a man who put out 8 videos?
I do love Craig Glazer. I'm
so
sorry.
I
really do. But
I do too.
And I don't think he would. The thing is, narcissists don't care if you talk badly about, they just don't believe it.
Well, they want you
and
to
I'm
talk
not
about
saying
it.
Anything. Yeah. I'm not saying anything bad. Craig, I think you, he's going to listen to this because someone's going to tell him and he likes people talking about him.
Yeah. Well, this is perfect. That's why we're going to watch his videos.
Okay. I don't want him being like, you know, Nikki Glaser. She used to be cool, and now she threw us under the bus.
She used to want to suck my brick. I said no for years. And this year I was getting ready to let her do it, and then she just fucked it all.
Ever?
I said, do 3 seasons on cable. And then I'll let you dip it in.
He exaggerates your credits. He's like, he said, I've been on SNL. Like, I'm walking on the stage being like, I have.
My favorite
I'm
one.
I'm the next Ellen DeGeneres. I'm like, that is so not who I am.
You dance a lot. You do dance a lot. I remember when I worked this club, when I drive, he's like, what else you got going on? I'm like, well, I'm writing this animated pilot with the co-head writer of SNL, but it's like super under wraps. Like, don't. And then someone sent me a blog post. My manager's like, hey, Craig, this guy, Craig Glazer, saying everyone about your deal. I was like, what? He's like, he told me he's writing a show that's going to star this. And I'm like, I didn't tell any of that shit.
Dude, I had to tell him and everyone in the chain of command of that club 5 times that I, in fact, have never toured with the Insane Clown Posse. They just put that on there with me. Yeah, is that what you're writing? Yeah.
Oh my God.
Every poster said that first and foremost.
On the Twitter, whenever they post about the open mic, they're like, are you the next Nikki Glaser? And I'm like, I hope not. These poor people, like, who?
There are so many women
the
in
new
Kansas
club's
City
pretty cool.
I hate you.
New club's pretty cool.
Where is it?
It's in Overland Park.
Oh, okay. And, they've had, it was at the Legends, before. Did you do the Legends?
I did Legends.
I liked the Legends one.
Yeah? I did not.
I liked Rainforest Cafe.
I never did Westport. I never did that one either.
I did the one behind the Hooters, though. That was the one I started at.
How much sniz do you think Craig Glazer got coming out of Hooters?
I mean, he
played center field.
Listen, he goes for every radio show he goes in with you.
If they have like a new young intern working there, he goes, she's already into me. But he hams it up. He plays it up.
Yeah. Yeah.
For you to go. So, but I wonder how much it works out for him. But he likes strippers and shit.
Yeah, he does.
He's like, I like pretty women. I like them young. So what are you going to do? Strippers. Like, is that the only way that works out?
Well, this guy, it's, you know, good solution to his
all
problem.
All young, pretty girls are strippers.
Everyone knows that.
And they all love giving HJs and Lotuses.
Christine, hit play. Lou Dog.
It's off, Lou.
Isn't the owner whose name is Mitzi? It's your son whose name is Paulie. Paulie and I have become good friends over the years. And back in the 90s, Paulie worked Stanford Sons of Westport a lot. But in the beginning, it was a little rocky because Paulie's kind of, you know, thinks he's a big deal. So I got to say one thing for Paulie Shore. While a lot of people may not dig a stand-up, and I can't be funny when he wants to be. Ladies, man, guys, no one got more girls than this guy, and I'm pretty good at it. This was our heyday. This was the 90s. So Paulie's up in my office, and we're kind of auditioning along the line.
Is he supposed to be telling the dogs a story?
Yeah, but pull that back about 10 seconds, because I just want to hear the long line of women that are lining up for Craig Glazer and Paulie Shore.
Oh, I bet it is great.
Oh, I bet there's a couple real just blown-out tire stomachs somewhere.
Chicks with that little bouffant in the front, and they're wearing bowling shirts.
Oh, it's lime green lips. Stick. They're like, I'm gonna fuck tonight.
The 90s. So Paulie's up in my office and we're kind of auditioning along the line. And I mean, every girl's in a mini skirt, they're all eights and nines. And of course, one of the hottest ones is a little Italian 19-year-old girl that I was dating at the time. And we all get along.
The hottest one's the one he was dating. Dude, this guy is great. He's the best.
I'm watching Nikki's face. It's just so fucking good.
I cannot believe this. What he's not talking to the dogs. The dogs is, he was just like, how do I tell my stories?
Yeah.
And then they were like, let's just have you be telling stories to the dog. The music in the background and the cuts.
No, it's great. You don't understand.
The dogs are being held against their will.
Yeah, the dogs are constantly trying to escape his grip. It's nonstop.
Oh my god.
The dogs are trying to take off.
Oh, look at him.
He's with the seven, and he has to, you know, steal my thunder. And he leans over and he goes, dude, I heard you did movies, yeah, man? And I went, yeah, I've done a few movies. I've been in movies. He goes, what were you, like, kind of an extra or something? You know, I star in my movies. And I go, I know that, Paulie, but at least my movies were A movies. Anyway, so the girl that I was with, he wanted, and he said, she came up to me later that night. I'm like, how many girls do you need? She goes, well, they've invited me to a party. It's already 3 in the morning. We're at a dance club in Westport. And the level's out. We're going to
dance club. He's manhandling those. Oh, my
I'm
God.
Go, you know, this party.
Junior, goddammit. I'm fucking up my two shot.
I feel like whoever's filming this and editing it is not on his side.
No, they're
they focus on the animal cruelty throughout the whole.
No, they know where the goods are.
I mean, the one on the right looks like a Sarah McLachlan, one of the Sarah McLachlan commercials.
Oh my god!
My favorite is right when the dog thinks it's getting away, he just mushes it into his chest.
That was aggressive.
Stay here. I'm talking about getting puss.
That was a great impression.
Nothing repels these dogs like my stories of puss. Because they have to be in the room to watch it.
Yeah, he goes, yeah.
Oh, those dogs have seen and then I put so my, much.
And then I put my hand in her. The very hands I hold these dogs with.
They don't like it, because, you know.
Let's hear the end here.
You know what? If you want to be the Paulie that bad, go ahead and go to their party. So I drove by the party a little later. And the party was Paulie, and then what I want to call my ex-girlfriend.
What a sad story. That was
Paulie Shore just fucked your girlfriend?
Dude, that was such a sad story. And by the way,
the end says hashtag think about it after every one. Like that.
That's going to be sweeping.
But I love the fact that was
what's episode 8 called? We could watch one more.
I mean, these are actually amazing.
Oh, they're priceless.
They are.
Yeah, are you kidding?
We've been itching to watch.
I called Jay on the road and just had him do Craig Glazer just to make me laugh in my hotel room.
He was crying, waking up my kids.
Oh, yes! I know the story. I know the story, actually.
Ooh, he has kids?
No.
The other dog died.
different episode.
What the fuck was that?
I always like for these stories to have some type of moral lesson. Things you guys can learn that an experienced bachelor, entrepreneur, somebody said entrepreneur, I'm in the camera here. So they know he's.
Oh my god!
Get over it, younger shit.
If he does this to these dogs on camera, what does he do when he's alone?
I don't know.
Get over here, you bag of garbage.
He grabbed. Okay, if you're not. You're not watching.
By the way, follow us at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat to see these videos.
This is Steve's episode 8. He grabs this dog so hard. I thought he was going to grab a script or something.
Like a lion cub.
It wasn't.
Hey, can you hand me that old shoe?
Oh,
it's just my
God.
Dog.
The dog
howled. What's that?
The dog howled when he did it.
Yeah.
Play that back.
Go back.
I can't even watch that again. That makes me so sad.
Hold on. You got to watch it because it's.
Oh, my God. There it is.
Get over here, hunk of shit.
Oh, no.
Oh, but he kisses it. He kisses it.
Look at it. Runs away again.
He really abusive husband, that dog. You're hurting me. He goes, you know, my baby. You know I love you, baby. Now get in there and make me some meat.
I mean, that was not good.
You're my one. You're my only.
You're my only one for sure. For real, for real.
For real.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
She worked at a club named Whispers out by Legends, which is in Kansas City, Kansas. That should have been my first clue. Plus, I told all my friends about her, and she was gorgeous, little skinny girl. She just looked like a little baby, and you wanted to save her. And everyone said, you're out of your mind. She has not one, not two, but three children out of wedlock. None of them are yours, and they're little kids, and they're mixed. I don't know why I had a huge crush on
them. None of them are yours?
And they're mixed. He had to throw that in.
Yeah, he really does.
Half Nick.
So, you know, they're not pure. They're not Aryan.
Oh, my God.
I call them Nick bits.
God damn it.
Years ago. So, we had a pretty serious relationship. I was totally loyal to her. And I'm thinking, how can I make this work? At the time, you're thinking of opening a Stanford Sons of my college.
Hey, it's me, your step-pop, Craig Glazer.
So I was going to L.A. I just sold my movie, The Book, The King's Sting. And at that time, it was going to be written for Mayhem at Disney. And I was going to work with the writer, other writer, David Young. I was flying into L.A. And I was all excited. But I thought I'd surprise Nikki, who I trusted, because I knew she was loyal. And she was a stripper of the heart of gold. So my manager, David, was dropping me off at the airport. It was about 10 or 11 o'clock at night. I go, let's stop by, because she lived kind of a bad neighborhood. I lived in a good neighborhood. I really didn't want to drive over there. But, you know, I want to say goodbye and surprise her. We pull up to her little apartment complex. I run up the steps, right, Coco? And knock on the door to give her a kiss goodbye on the way to the airport to L.A. That's about 10:45 p.m. The door opens. There's a guy 6'5 in the doorway. It wasn't Nikki. He goes, you're waking up my kids. And I'm like, what? I look at the apartment. I bring mom at the wrong apartment. Dave goes, you're not at the wrong apartment. Let's go. I had a couple of cocktails at the car on the way to the airport. And I go, what do you mean? The guy goes, you're waking up my kids. And I went, what? And Dave goes, let's go. Because then I see what's coming next. I'm going, wait a minute. This guy's, oh my God, this guy's with my girlfriend. He's in there doing the dirty stuff with poor little Nikki, my girlfriend. And I'm on the way to L.A. to do this $1 million deal. And she's like, run, upset me. So she called me later that night, swore that it was her baby's daddy, and he was just watching the kids, and, you know, that she wasn't there, and she was out drinking, right? You want to believe it because you love him, right?
Yeah, so you wouldn't believe she left her kids to go drink.
Yeah, with the guy that she left, who also is the father of those kids.
Yeah.
You want to believe it.
Oh, my God, did you go by my house? That's so weird. My baby's daddy was there babysitting while I was just putting one on.
Oh, thank God.
You got me. I believe in hook, line, and sinker.
This.
I love you, so I'll go.
I believe you this time. You're the king of sting.
Moral
what,
of story.
What is this? What is this?
What is this?
That's Black Barbie.
Oh.
That's Black Barbie.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Is he still seeing her?
He says it's his number one girlfriend, I think.
Oh, number one?
His main one.
Oh, okay.
I hope she doesn't slip in the polls.
It's complicated.
Yeah.
Eating at a restaurant, and she was on her knees telling me she swore in her baby's lives that she wouldn't lie. She was not sleeping with that guy. When she left to go to the bathroom, the waitress came over, and she goes, are you Craig Glazer? And I went, yeah. And she goes, I'm her neighbor. I babysit for her. She wanted me to lie for her, but I'm a good Christian. She said, when you pounded on the door, the baby's daddy had his pants down, and they were in bed together, and she didn't know what to do, and she wanted me to lie for her. So how did it end? I was letting her use my Mercedes, a used car. Yeah, we picked that car up. That's the car we drive the comedians around in today. I don't see Nikki anymore. The lying little bitch. Right, Coco?
What?
He is taking his anger out on the dog.
Yeah.
This is like...
Think about it.
Send
think
it to PETA.
Hashtag think about it, Nikki. Think about what those dogs go through.
But for real, though, think about it.
But like, are you thinking about it?
Hold on. I mean...
You got to learn your lesson.
You know, I can't leave it open this much. You got to play episode 7.
You want 7? Yeah, you don't want to
save it? And then we'll take a commercial.
Is 7 good? Is 7?
I don't know.
Have you guys seen all of these?
No.
Oh,
we're
okay.
Watching. We were up to 6. So okay. This is 7. So we got
to
do 7.
I go to the door. He comes to the door holding his dick in his hand.
He goes, you're waking up my kid.
That's good.
I throw the dog at him.
Dog's there. Dog's biting on his knees.
Anyway.
Anywho.
They just had to kick the dog a couple times for that sound bite. Come here, Junior. Oh my god, that
Junior's
dog.
Frail.
Starving.
Hey, it's time for Ann and his dog. But my two best friends and my live-in buddies, Junior, who I had for over 13 years of miniature dogs, and Coco, the chihuahua pup that Chocolate Becky left me for a weekend. I've had
he always calls
years.
It
anyway,
Chocolate
you,
Becky.
You gotta be careful when you use appliances, guys, especially when they're related to having sex. Back in LA, and I wrote this in my book, The King of Stay, I had a little girl used to come over, really cute, great figure, I remember long, dark black hair, but she partied so hard, she would pass out. One given night, I bought, you know, everybody has these vibrators that have the batteries and all that, and yeah. Kind of a dildo.
I know the type.
All right, here's the deal. I'll give you a trick. Don't use
Hold
those.
On. Pause
use
it, Christine. Board. Christine, pause it. You should be as Jiminy Cricket. You're as conscious.
Yeah.
I have
Slow
to
down,
just say.
Greg. Slow down.
I'm impressed at the length of these videos. They're, like, actually a good length.
Oh, whoever's doing this, first off, is great at editing.
Right.
Because when he just said that, party,
yeah,
till
great.
She passed out. That was a good, that was almost an Eric Andre cut.
No one has enough restraint to make anything on YouTube under 3 minutes, and Craig Glazer has done it. I will applaud him for how quick these videos are.
So you think
they could go viral.
Chocolate Becky, Black Barbie, dildos, dogs there.
That's my elbow. That's
yeah,
my
please,
elevator.
Please,
bitch.
Be his. Yeah, Jiminy Cricket.
Lotus, high five,
high five, banging bitches, dogs,
banging bitches, dog. Jeff's there, Dad, Westport.
I just imagine him in like a conference
DJ
room.
DJ Miller.
Him in a conference room, going, shut your eyes now. Two dogs, me, leather couch.
He is a
stories
legends mall. TJ Miller. Lewis Black, Larry the Cable Guy, before he's famous.
Dave Attell, said I was one of his favorites.
Dave Attell brought me on stage, opened in a theater, did a thing. Lotus.
$300 worth of steak. That's fine.
Girls take advantage, bang strippers. Lotus, Denny's, Morning Radio, Johnny Dare.
He's always in a feud with Johnny Dare.
Johnny Dare hates me because I laughed when he asked me if I was going to go see Jackal that night in 2014.
And you laughed right in his face.
And I laughed. I go, no, I'm not. He's like, what's wrong with that? I go, nothing, man. But it's like, you know, you said it with such confidence, like I was definitely going to go see Jackal tonight. And he's like, what's wrong with Jackal? I'm like, nothing's wrong with Jackal. I mean, and he goes, oh, you know, Jackal's, the lead singer Jackal's best friends with Johnny Dare. I go, all right, but Johnny Dare should know. Like, why would you set somebody up to be in that position? Like, you're not asking me if I'm going to go see fucking Billy Joel at the thing, or even the like Guns and Roses, you know, somebody's like, Jackal? No, I'm all right.
The lead singer.
I'm not seeing Dokken or Warrant either.
The lead singer of Jackal, he owes Johnny Dare $20.
So he's Jackal's there. Johnny Dare, 95.1. Today's country music.
Chocolate Becky.
Chocolate Becky, Panera Bread, Denny's, Lotus.
Tie on the dogs.
Use Mercedes. Dog's there. Junior. Everyone, update. I've kicked Junior retarded. So...
Turns out he was dead. Episode 4.
Junior died. Dog's here. Babe's here. Choking this dog. Pretend it's Black Becky. Chocolate Barbie.
I treat the dog like it's a bim.
Dog's a bim.
All right, let's play one
What's
more video.
What's a BIM?
Hey, Bimbo.
Oh.
Use the plug-in ones, right, Junior? Use the plug-in ones that are, you know, electric. You know why? Bam! Stronger. Bam! It's got a big head on it. I should show you. And it looks like a back massager. Yeah.
Yeah, the magic
wand. Well, that way when the maid comes and she's cleaning up, you're not embarrassed when she got like a big penis dildo. You go, oh, that's the back massager. We know it's for sex, but it's a cover-up story. All right, so I have this out, and the top's got a big bulbous rubber head, right, Coco? Then there's a metal thing that holds the rubber thing, bing, and that thing goes crazy when you plug it in, and then there's the long, you know, whatever, arm that is kind of vibrator thing. All right, so I plug it in. I have the girl back in the bedroom. Gina, I think was her name. I'm doing everything crazy. We're having sex. Bring out the vibrator. She lays it on herself. But I remember the head was getting loose on it, and she had passed out. Well, I'm making this a late-night dinner. I'm trying to be a good guy. I'm trying to be polite. I'm trying to take care of her. So I go out and get the food, and I think I smell bacon burning, right? And I went, I didn't make any bacon. Oh my God, it wasn't bacon. The rubber head had come off the vibrator, and the thing was vibrating, and it was almost on fire. It was like a hot poker coal. She passed out. It was laying on her pussy, and her pussy was being cooked. So I did all I could. I had to take her to the hospital. I don't know if they sewed her pussy shut or not. I never saw her again. But I'll tell you what, I don't need bacon anymore.
Rubber head, plug in appliances, pussy cooked.
That story, if it's true, is fucking insane.
You know, it's funny. Me and Christine were the owners of a plug-in magic wand thing.
Yeah.
And at one point, remember, it started fucking fired sparks out.
What?
Yeah, dangerous.
Wait a second.
Singed bush.
That's like my favorite thing. It really malfunctioned?
Yeah.
Well, better hope you get a good one.
Send us a new one.
They can go wonky.
Oh, they sent
you
a new one?
They end up sending a new one.
That's
nice. It's kind of scary.
I go in there. She's half on fire. It's a puzzle fire.
She's on fire. Puss cook.
I dropped her off at the hospital. Never saw her again.
Deep fried box.
I don't know if they...
Sona pussy. Lotus dog.
Sona.
Deep fried box. Deep fried box. It's so goddamn funny.
She's there. Plug in. Sizzle clit. Hospital.
Let's take our last break, Daniel.
Oh my God.
Nikki Glaser's here with us. We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
Hi, this is Nikki Glaser, and you're listening to The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder. I've slept with one of them.
Norman Bates, it's The Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95, Old Dirty Bastard. Wednesdays. I'm Dan Soder, that's Big J. Oakerson. Our guest from the show Not Safe, Nikki Glaser. It's going to be at Caroline's tomorrow through Saturday?
Yeah, Sunday.
Sunday.
I didn't know until now.
The podcast Not Safe with Nikki Glaser is also available on iTunes, and you can catch full episodes of the show on cc.com. You can get tickets for Nikki at Caroline's at NikkiGlaser.com. You can also see Big J. Oakerson in Greenville, South Carolina at the Comedy Zone tomorrow through Saturday. BigJComedy.com for tickets, and also download his special live from Webster Hall on iTunes. Download Nikki's special on iTunes and download mine. Just go get a three-peat.
Yeah, get a three-peat. And,
three-peat.
And check out Dan Soder at the Vermont Comedy Club in Burlington this Friday, August 19th, and Saturday, August 20th. Make sure you get your tickets at DanSoder.com. I'll tell you what, Nikki, about your show. I'm sure you've been complimented by a zillion comics about it, but I mean, you guys doing a... I really was on the road one night and just watched. They did like a marathon of it one night, and just like you guys doing, you and Kyle Kinane.
Yeah,
that's my
Hillary 2016.
Oh my God!
Fucking doing the voices. I'm doing a bad description here, but like, have you guys like doing the voice? They're telling them in their earpiece
what to say
while they're doing an actual full penetration porn was fucking hilarious.
It's nuts.
What was the energy like? Because you have to be like on the porn set. So were you like?
Yeah. They're in a separate room, so I'm not seeing all that. But it's crazy to see. And I was asking them, they're like, this is a short day for us. Usually these shoots take like 6 hours or whatever. Like,
and then you did one with Moshe Kasher too, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, and Kristen Shaw.
Awesome.
I've chickened out before on Yoshi. Remember Yoshi would come around?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
The comic from LA, but he worked on porn sets, and he was like, hey, I can get you on a porn set, and I, I'd almost make an excuse to not go.
Yeah.
Because I was like, it just seems weird and uncomfortable. And true to that being the case, one time we all went to Amsterdam.
Yeah.
A bunch of comics, and me and Joe DeRosa, I remember we're both there for that. But you sit there, and they do, it says the live sex show, but they do a bunch of strippers first, come out and do the striptease, and we're all laughing and making fun of it and having a good time and giggling. And then a couple comes out. When they start fucking, everyone just gets very, like, weirdly quiet. You're like, okay.
Yeah, that is weird.
Yeah, and I'm as open-minded and filthy as it could be. I just, when you just see it, you're in a room, you're just kind of like, it's just pretty real, huh? Like, they're just fucking.
You start hearing that skin, like...
Yeah. Have you ever? I assume you've been in like threesomes and orgies and stuff, and hooked up with girls while other guys were hooking up with girls. Do you ever just? Is there ever a time when you're doing a threesome with another? Do you do like two guys and a girl? Have you ever done that?
In my life, not with Christine. Christine's about the girls.
Yes.
Christine likes.
I
chicks.
Know that. I just heard that recently.
Gross.
But so gross. No, it's awesome. But do you ever like feel weird watching her with a girl? Obviously not.
No.
Do they ever get too into it that you're just like, hey, I'm over here. You're like doing Sudoku.
Not even sort of. I'm totally fine with that. Whatever makes everybody happy. I don't know how weird I'd feel about a guy. I feel weird if it was a guy that I know in those situations. Mm-hmm. Unless it's a girl I don't know. Like, I've done things with another guy and a girl, like, just both guys doing stuff to the girl only.
Yes.
But I mean, like, and if I know the guy, I don't know the girl very well, so it's kind of like, who gives cares? A shit?
Are you guys just kind of like, do you ever, like, make eye contact, the guys?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
And kind of look at, like, you've been in this situation, too?
Yeah. Oh, me and a buddy one time with a girl, and while he was looking up at me, I was behind her. I was giving, like, air guitar. Like,
that's so funny that you guys, like, kind of, like, wink at each other. Like, this is pretty awesome.
He finished fast, and I was like, huh?
Yeah.
It was my
girl. Wait, when did you do it?
I was like, 20.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, and I came back from college.
I love it.
Me and my buddy Adam.
I was last week.
That's what Andy and I just did in the bathroom.
Nice. I know we have to wrap up here soon.
I know.
This went so fast.
That's why I said we should have had Nikki for 90 minutes.
I know.
I wish.
We gotta try to woo her now. And our plan was coming up here.
Yeah.
In the Woo Nikki contest.
So who would you like to try to woo you first with musical talent?
It's your choice. Who goes first? Should we each get our reason for why one should go first?
Yes.
The other?
Yeah, I think that's only fair.
I was gonna say... Because Soder's are...
Yeah, I think going last for you would be your best bet.
You think going last for Jay would be the best bet?
Because I feel like that I would have forgotten about you by the time... If you have the advantage, then I will have forgotten about... It's like when they give the rose and the bachelorette. The first person is always the one who loses.
Okay, so see, my thought process was I was going to go second because I need to win you back. Can non-drinking Dan win you back through the talents, musical talents?
Will you be crying during it?
I mean, this is it's a song that brings up a lot of emotions. And I'll tell you this.
Guys, I don't know.
It's a song that I know you, and that's why I chose you. That's why I chose this song.
Okay, let's do Big J first.
No, you know what? I'm going to say this.
Big J first.
I'm so confident in my musical choice.
Executive call, you're going to go first?
I'm going to go first.
Okay.
Is yours going to be a closer? In terms of, like, am I going to respond in a more, like, closer way?
I want you to look at me, and so, cool as a cucumber. I'm not worried about it. Let him go first.
Okay.
I think...
Never question that Big J can close.
All right. Let's do it.
I don't want to see.
Don't see.
I'm not... I just didn't...
Gotta play the music loud, though, Lou. Let us feel it.
Honestly, getting turned on already.
So, I gave him a singing lesson earlier.
You got your ball, you've got your chain tied to me tight, tie me up again. Who's got their claws in you, my friend? Into your heart I'll beat again. Sweet like candid to my soul. Sweet you rock and sweet you roll. Not even looking. Lost for you, I'm so lost for you.
Into
me, baby. and I come into you.
Well, this is dirty.
Yeah, pretty erotic stuff. So that's my little song.
All right.
We're not gonna do the whole thing. We don't have enough time. We gotta do.
No, I'm doing the whole thing.
I don't want to hear that whole thing.
Okay, yeah, that's pretty good too. I'm doing the whole thing at all, so that was just kind of fun. So you could see my selection.
It was very thoughtful.
Thank you.
Deduct points for only looking at Big J the whole time you sang it.
Well, no. Here's the thing: is I was feeling like it was getting too intense between
you
and me.
Oh, really? I don't.
So
I don't,
to like look off at like Jay.
I can tell you it's not.
Okay. Well, you know what? I was gonna do Don't Drink the Water, and I should have done that because.
Oh, that would have been a deep cut. No, that was amazing. I've never had any man sing Dave Matthews to me, and it is it brings so much nostalgia.
Yeah.
And immediately I was turned on. It's a great choice.
I should have, and I feel bad. I should have worn a puka shell necklace to really brought the whole thing in.
That's God damn it, that would have been amazing if you put it on right as the guitar started.
I'm really regretting it. And I should have brought in my acoustic axe.
Oh my God, like a hemp bracelet.
Oh yeah. And maybe done the Dave walk.
God, you know it. All right,
Jay, follow that.
Oh, you're one quarter of a song? Cool, I'll get a shot.
By the way,
crank it up, Lou. Give me some reverb.
Than you, and I will never find another lover more precious than you, precious than you. Girl, you are close to me like my mother, close to me like my father, close to me like my sister, close to me like my brother, brother, brother. You are the only one, you're my everything, and for you the song I sing all my pray for someone like you, and I thank God that I finally found you. All my life I pray for someone like you, and I hope that you feel the same way too. Yes, I pray that you do.
This is so fun.
Oh, we don't get to the breakdown.
Oh, I can't wait.
Blow your mind. Everyone's in.
Said I promised to never fall in love with a stranger. You're all I'm thinking of. I praise the Lord above for sending me your love. I cherish every hug. I really love you. Baby,
pray for someone like you.
And I thank God that I finally found you. All my life I pray for someone like you, and I hope that you feel the same way too. Yes, I pray that you do.
Come on, everyone.
You're all that I have ever known. When you smile, my face always seems to glow. And you turn my life around. You pick me up when I was down. You're all that I ever know. When you smile, my face glows. You pick me up when I was down. Say you're all that I ever know. When you smile, my face glows. You pick me up when I was down. And I hope that you feel the same way too.
I mean, I don't even
know. Yes, I pray that you do love me too.
I don't even think this is a competition.
It's fantastic.
Nikki, go with him.
Oh my God.
Go with him.
Well, I'm going to.
Nikki, go.
Jay, I gotta go with you because you picked a song. You could have picked a song from like before. That is right at my age level of like I loved it.
Christine called that in the subway here.
So good, Christine.
I mentioned that song and she goes no because that's perfect because we were gonna do
Genuine Bachelor.
I don't know that song.
Exactly.
I would have been so disappointed if I didn't know it. At first when it started, I was like, is this some like slow jam that I was like, you know.
Yeah.
I was going to do Def Leppard, Bringing On the Heartache, but then I was...
No, Casey and JoJo.
It was so good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, speaking of so good...
I am so flattered.
Check out the So Good Show. Well, it's not...
The So Good Show.
It's...
That is not safe.
That's the So Good Show that
I wanted to rename
safe.
It to that.
At So Good Show. Yeah. At Nikki Glaser on Twitter. If you're in the New York area, go to Caroline's and check her out tomorrow through...
I've known Nikki for so long.
Sunday.
She's fucking hilarious.
Really
Thank
one of my
you.
Favorite comedians and one of my favorite people. At Big J Oakerson on Twitter, at The Bonfire SXM on Twitter, at Dan Soder on Twitter. We love you.
Go see Dan in Vermont, everyone.
Go see Jay in South Carolina, and we will see you guys Monday. Lou, Andy, Christine, Jacob, we love you all.
Bye.
Thanks, guys.